I'm getting whiplash. Okay, they have not even touched this girl. And now we're finally gonna see, talk about Isabel? I feel like she has been ignored. I thought she wasn't even in Limbus until now. But we're actually going to address Isabel. Okay. Let's see how this goes.
이것 좀 확인해야 할 것 같은데요.
Uh-oh. You guys might want to come take a look at this.
아까 쓰러뜨린
Look at the corpse of the dead rabbit's boss we defeated earlier.
죽은 건
This isn't Heathcliff from the other world. I don't think we've ever seen this person before.
이건 처음 보는 사람의 시체잖아요.
Are we also not going to address the body coming? Oh no, that's the body in front of. I think Catherine's still inside. Quote unquote Catherine. That the planes are rising still though. Heavens, this is. I know her. So, not dead. Wait, huh? Okay, dead rabbit, not Matt, Mirror World Heath.
Isabella 아가씨.
Is Miss Isabel?
대체...
Did Catherine use Isabel's body as like a conduit? This is kind of what I was thinking of. The pods are conduits to bring, to connect to the mirror worlds and bring people out of them. That's why we're getting IDs. What would be an ID from a mirror world into our world by means other than Dante? Because Dante is the only one who seems to have the power to pull the IDs, if I remember some of the other explanations. But he's the one to pull them and assign them, and that's what our whole selection screen is for. Of he gets the information to then put them toward the sinners so they get new abilities and whatnot when they go into battles. But Catherine's pod system here is taking bodies from the current world and like overwriting them with the mirror ID. Miss Isabel, how could this... Isabel?
Isabella Edgar.
Isabel Edgar, Linton's younger sister.
Linton과 함께
she came by this manor a few times along with Linton. They overwrote Linton's sister with Heathcliff's ID?
그놈은 진짜가 아니었어.
He wasn't even real.
놓친 거야.
We lost him. This technology they're using to summon identities, it's definitely a lot like our own. There have been a total of 4 separate instances of lightning strikes. That's scaring me now. Meadow was the first to break the silence. The most logical course of action from the perspective of our company would have been to wait until the golden ball becomes available to us, just as Linton had suggested earlier. But hide in the barn and wait for the 7th strike of lightning like cowards?
그래.
What a helpful lot you are. Thank you kindly for your words of encouragement. You know what? We should have done that from the start. It was foolish of me to even... Allow me to finish, Heathcliff. I am beginning to feel the need to practice hastening my speech. We have experienced consistent escalation of risk merely by moving about the manor. Moreover, it is growing increasingly difficult to ensure Heathcliff's safety. Therefore, in conclusion, Marisol paused for a moment. I judge that we may have to stop the lightning from striking. Ooh. Ooh. This actually sounds probably plausible. The lightning strikes are something potentially powering, getting stronger. So it might be time to put a little kibosh on that. Even if that decision leads to our failure to obtain the golden ball. Everyone fell silent, deep in thought after hearing Marisol's judgment. It wasn't a decision based on cold, hard facts that we've come to expect from him. I don't know what facts we have for him to judge by, just because there's pods with kidnapped people and a 7 lightning strike omen? Instruction? But, like, should we trust the instruction? There's logic here. There's a little. Based on some fact. Agreed. It never appeared that the lightning strikes were a result of natural phenomena. Yeah, we thought it was a security system. It all struck at the most dramatic moments, almost on a certain trigger. Killing the manor's power without fail. Okay, let's think about this. Let's think about the circumstances. Surrounding each lightning strike of lightning. First one was, yeah, at the funeral. When they were reading Catherine's will. Is that the first one? We're not counting the one with Sir Squirrel before we entered the gate? No, we can get a bit more specific than that. It was when Heathcliff called out Catherine's name. The second one was when Linton said something hurtful to Heathcliff, all that verbal abuse. The third was when Henley drew his last breath, and thus all is ruined. Linton's exhausted voice broke through our musings. He looks around at the destroyed laboratory, the corpses, the husks of dead Pectula. There was a hollow look in his eyes. His face already so sallow. Sallow. That's an interesting word. Of unhealthy yellow or pale brown color. Had lost even more of its color, but he stood tall. Linton's gaze lingers for a moment on his sister's mangled corpse before moving toward Catherine in the coffin. Isabel, my dear sister. So this is how our reunion was to be. It feels like it was just yesterday that you left our home without a word. You didn't even write to each other? She did send me a few childish letters that she met her fated partner, that she found true love. But she couldn't possibly introduce me to this person, as I would surely refuse to give my blessing. I wonder... No, because she was forced onto a Mirror Heath. But maybe another Mirror Heath seduced her? Because she originally marries Heath in the book. I thought we were going to have multiple Catherines. Are we getting more Heathcliffs?
No.
You. Do you even understand what you've done? I merely follow the path laid before me. The lightning has struck 4 times. Yeah, we know. We know how to count, you know. Executive manager, I can tell from the way the man is speaking that he may know the conditions that trigger the lightning strikes. Oda spoke plainly without even trying to lower her voice. Lightning strikes. Each strike of lightning is a blessing, for it signifies that you have a place in her heart. Linton looked straight toward Heathcliff, and I could finally see his face clearly for the first time. He wore the expression of deep, bottomless pain. It didn't change the fact that Linton was extremely suspicious and had quite a lot of things to answer for, but it began to sink in that he was also a man who was grieving for someone he loved. I lied to you, Heathcliff. Our marriage was never happy. But I have spent my entire life struggling to earn a place in her heart. knocking and knocking so that she would let me in. Yet there was nothing. She never once gave me an answer. Even now, she remains silent. Linton, nothing. None of that justifies the atrocity that you have committed in building this abominable laboratory. I've given some thought as to how so many people could disappear without leaving a shred of evidence. It cannot be said that the gangs kidnapped them by force, for there were no signs of resistance. There have also been cases of simultaneous disappearances. Sometimes even entire families would disappear all at once. You actually read the whole article? Then it can be reasoned that they weren't taken against their will. It would be more believable to say that they followed their would-be kidnappers willingly. Probably because they were gonna get paid. Which means the kidnapper was someone well-known, someone with a decent reputation. What? Did you offer them a job at the manor? Promise to treat them to a nice meal or something? An experiment to produce a human, or so it was called. Yet I cannot imagine a single human being for whom these heinous experimentations, all the sacrifice, this suffering, would be worth it for. Master Linton, even if it was Catherine, who would ask you to do this? This is too...
What?
Oh. Catherine, she asked you to do all this? No. That's impossible. Linton receives the sinner's deluge of resentful accusations with an unstirring expression. Yes. I will not deny that everything was by Catherine's request. But it was by my will that every one of her requests were carried out to the letter. I'm asking you why. The why never mattered to me, so I never asked her. All I ever cared about was endlessly endeavoring to carry out her wishes, to do as I was told. Linton, I feel, is almost in the same boat as Heathcliff, in a way. For, different reasons. Yeah, still, why? With your family's wealth, you could have just lied about the rest of your days in complete luxury with money to spare, so why? Should Tika or Neil be made aware of what transpired here, you may be subjected to a high degree of punishment, even if your family name were to mitigate it. You ask me why, is it not obvious? Because I loved Catherine. Ever since the moment I laid my eyes upon her, to this very day, I have spent every single moment of my life pining for her. You're just desperately begging for her attention, blinded by your own obsession? Speak ill of me if you will, I care not. Because my joy comes from what morsels of affection she spared me. So you have no idea how much I envied you, Heathcliff. You envied me. You. Even in her youth, when I would come to spend time with Catherine at this manor, she would always ask me the same question. I wonder where Heathcliff has gone to. I wish he was here. Of course, you must have been hiding from her, for you could not bear the sight of us. And believe it or not, it was not I who burned your letters. In truth, I would have delivered them to her myself had I had my hands on your letters, because that was how desperately Catherine was waiting for your news. Once you left, Catherine, she shut herself off in her room, refused to eat, and withered away, gazing into a mirror day and night until one day she calmly emerged from that very room and asked me for my hand, a mirror. She mentioned the same thing in the diary, that she saw herself in the mirror. Yet we kept no mirrors at the manor we lived. The mirror she looked into was, according to her, a gift. A gift from who? If you would like to know what she saw in that mirror, what it is that she saw that prompted her to ask to marry me, Why don't you ask the diary yourself? Ask that old diary that remains in obstinate silence before me. I'm gonna stick with the same crew? Question mark? Get this back to Ufi, actually. You're going to fight us in your state. If you seek to disturb this experiment, then it falls to me to stop you. What are you even looking to gain from this by going this far? The same thing as always. I love Catherine, so I shall do as she wills me to. So then I may enter her room. I dare not wish to become a master of it. I merely wish that she would let me in. The mere sight of an opened door, that little gesture would do more than enough. The thunder of every lightning that struck the manor was the sound of her heartbreak. Her breaking heart. With every heartbreak, the lightning strikes. The pain, the bereavement, the shock are all manifest as lightning, then darkness. Thus, the lightning only indicates that the person in question was so important to her. Hey, Cliff, I think Nelly was right. Catherine's still alive. It wasn't exactly the science or anything like that, but I've been feeling that gaze coming from somewhere within the manor. Not an aggressive gaze, no, but it was certainly stubborn and lingering. Yeah, because how would her heart know to break?
카론, 기다리는 거 못해.
So wait.
100초만 기다려줄게.
Hinley's last breath was one. Heath being berated was another. Shit, I'm already forgetting the other two. Well, that's great. Good job, Ishii. Dodge those attacks.
제가 도움이 될지는 모르겠지만 노력해 보겠습니다.
That was neutral. Damn it.
조심하셔야 해요. 정신이나 몸이 다친 동료들은 어떻게 바뀔지 모르니까요. Calorie 잘 드네요. 아마 그 공격이 약점이었겠죠?
Reset. For the very least, I need to bring a different group. If we keep going with these kind of fights. Maybe. Turns, but it's also like
no.
I'm trying to consider for the EX as well.
이 방식을 기억하는 게 좋겠어요. 탈출 개체가 정리되었습니다.
정리하겠습니다. 불결한 것.
승객이 딱콩 한 방 먹였어.
완전히 녹아내렸네.
방해꾼 하나가 사라졌군.
이렇게.
탈출 개체 확인.
Where's my name? Fine.
나이코.
Thank you, boss. I didn't get Yi Song Spice Boat re-leveled up. Multi-hit moves are just so good. Dang it, Ishii. Bye, Ishii.
또 다시 돌아오겠구려.
Sorry.
그 잠시나.
Ishii, I failed.
휴식하시오.
넌 무슨 맛일까?
외우 피해 적법. 지금이라도 말 들어.
들린다. 저 밑에서 안 돼야지.
피는 확실히 빼는 편이 좋지.
한 모금 마시기 전에.
너 맛 취.
적확한 한합이었어.
단테님.
Yeah, there's three left and four of us.
있는 거죠?
조심하랬지?
어. I mean, if I don't get a yes, it's not gonna be the worst. But I think otherwise, this is fine.
무슨 맛일까?
이 isn't even a Linton fight.
환상의 세계로 들어가 보죠.
Definitely gonna want to switch out, I think.
항상 지켜보고 있었지.
지금이라도 말 들어.
야호.
Turned in.
이기는 편.
우리 편.
무슨 맛일까?
방해꾼
Perfect.
하나가 사라졌고.
We hit the EX. I feel bad for Isabel. Isabel is like the most tragic person. Possibly. At least of this story so far. Because girl has been not been in any flashbacks. She shows up and is just dead. Was forced to be a Heath ID and just now dead. So there isn't anyone left. I won't last much longer. This is how I was born, how I've lived my entire life. Yeah, glad you know that. So why don't you admit my sins and surrender? Why would any of that ever matter to me? Linton looks up with a lighter expression as though a burden has been lifted from his shoulders.
나는
This is as far as I will go. Then with the gentlest voice he begins speaking to someone. His voice was overflowing with intense, fervent affection. As I have always told you, I have no regrets. I merely think that we were both walking in different paces. And you always happened to walk ahead of me. Yet even a sight of you from behind summoned butterflies in my stomach. This man will die without immediate and appropriate medical attention from a professional doctor. He is extremely weakened. Still, Catherine, I wish my death would bring you even a trace of sorrow. Even before I first laid my eyes upon that child, Linton, he was watching me, unable to look away even for a moment. That child is wealthy. He looks like the Prince Charming from fairy tales of my childhood. And he loves me so, so much. See? His eyes glimmer with the very stars of the night sky with every second he lays them upon me. I love Linton, who loves me. This is what I hate about Catherine. It is the I love Linton because who loves me? Because he loves me, I love him. That's not good. His eyes that twinkle for no one else but me. His flaxen locks that flow for no one else but me. His radiant smile that flashes for no one else but me. Linton, who finds happiness through nothing else but me. When the light returned to the manor, when I could finally see again, there stood Linton, wearing the brightest, happiest smile I'd ever seen. The machineries of the laboratory were linked to his body. Did you hear the thunder? Catherine weeps for me. Oh, Catherine. Linton musters every last strength in his body and reaches out towards Catherine's coffin. Wait, what are you? So now, is the right moment to?
Stop!
I thought I saw tears of joy rolling down his cheeks, but they were his flesh beginning to melt off his face. Even if you will not permit me into your chamber, it's all right. I will await you within its walls forevermore.
언젠가에 순수했던 인간을 만드는 방법은
I thought you left the Seiya to bring forth the pure form of humanity that once existed was quite the simple task.
요리에는 죽었다 깨어나도
You never had any talent in the culinary arts, Yisong. So you wouldn't understand. Any kind of identity could safely and securely be applied to it as long as the dough is in its purest form. Dough? What happened to Linton? Can't you see? He's become a dough, a batter, a pure being free of dregs. So that it would always yield the finest result, regardless of what other ingredients you mix into it. You call that mass of flesh human. No. Creation of a new human is but a stepping stone in that process. Their ultimate goal must be to go even further beyond that dough. They seek to reach the very origin, the primordial human. This is but part of that process, merely an experiment along the way.
Oh,
consider yourself fortunate that there aren't any other surviving researchers here other than myself. If Dr. Herman or any other higher ups heard what you said, I'm sure they would be pulling all kinds of strings to take you in. Mother damn it, I knew that woman would be. The doe, the being you refer to as a human, I presume that one could apply to any identity from any possibility, no matter how distant and irrelevant the world to that being. Yes, Yisang, I knew that you would be the most overjoyed to hear of this breakthrough. I don't think I heard joy. This is the apex of what the mirror technology is capable of. Now all we have left to do is leap from that apex to soar beyond its limits. We need to burn this place to the ground. I'm just saying. From what we know, there is another golden ball located inside the manor. The dough is part of an experiment that can be conducted only with a preposterous magnitude of energy output. So the golden ball, to accumulate that much energy, must be located on the rooftop of this manor. Correct. The golden ball acts as a lightning rod and draw once the merciless strikes of lightning, then harnesses it in a form of energy for itself. Your breadth of knowledge is starting to get unsettling. Well, now that everything is in order, I must really make my exit. Not so fast. I'll get you and find out everything you know about what my mother is planning. Please let us not waste each other's time by playing this pointless game of cat and mouse. When the perfected identity is applied over a dough, one such opaque, murky mist emerges. What a picturesque moment. For most apt to bid you a farewell, is it not? Director Herman's son, was it? I hear that you are a veteran of the Smoke War. Then perhaps this may be a familiar sight to you, if a tad different in a few places. And Yisang, my dear fellow, live so that you may have aught to look forward to in time. Live so that I may have aught to look forward to in the time I have left. The Wild Hunt. A perfected identity. Who is he talking about? He's coming back. Heathcliff, now fully primed. Yes, I have returned. I, whose existence itself has become a sin, have returned to put an end to us all. You. Josephine. You accursed beast, infernal demon, who finally come back to take our manor, have you? Mistress, I shall not let that interloper, who dared to stain the honor of our manor. I was wondering why Josephine wasn't murdered. I thought she was going to be a different boss fight later, but I guess not. Every Wuthering Heights, at the end of all things in every world, eventually became mine. Every single death Hindley and Linton suffered was pathetic and writhing, and that shall be an immutable truth for all eternity to come. Thus, Josephine, it is only right that you are mine as well. You are bound to heed my commands. Mistress, this vagabond, I tire of your ramblings of your mistress. She is nothing but a rotten corpse, her flesh decaying and bones desiccated. Oof. Josephine fell a limp and motionless in Heathcliff's grasp. Josephine. Hindley Linton. All of these pitiful souls tangled and fettered to this accursed destiny in every world. I have seen you far too many times in far too many worlds. I shall take you away from here, you pitiful souls who remain bound to Wuthering Heights, even in death. The husks of dead Petula, Lintons, Henleys, Josephines all began to materialize and rise. They begin to form a procession. The countless bodies husk and wailing things in their wake. All joined the march. Oh, shit! Thus approached the final chapter of this tale. The other Heathcliff stands at on the vanguard of the march and lifts Catherine's coffin onto his back. You can't do that to Catherine. Fine, I suppose we could play a game. It has been a while, hasn't it? Remember, we used to play games with Catherine on the rooftop of this manor. Why not reminisce upon that sweet memory, If you wish to join us, pursue me. Pursue me and rise to the stairwell of until your strength fails, Heathcliff. Heathcliff takes a big step, a step forward to seize him, but the endless march stands in his way. Oh. But it will not be that easy, nor should it be. Your heart towards Catherine shan't be realized so painlessly. You must suffer more. Let desperation consume you. Become frenzied in your pursuit. The rooftop. Indeed. The roof houses the golden ball. When the two golden balls come into physical contact with one another, they... can think of a thousand different outcomes. I don't know what he's planning to do with Catherine, but we have to stop him. We have to. Our retreat's been cut off. No way forward, no way back. Are they Henley, Linton, and Josephine from other worlds? They appear to be imperfect identities, summoned from worlds chosen at random. It is the fate that awaits all those who become thralls to the at Heathcliff. A phenomenon in which a mirror world entity wreaks havoc across the dimensions in pursuit of every Heathcliff. In other words, the Wild Hunt. I'm vaguely like there was the rebirth. My friend brought up near comparisons. I'm now getting just a tiny bit of Witcher. My Witcher knowledge is less than some other things. Like the nocturnal march of 100 demons. So there's no end to them. He is the conduit that has brought them all to this world. He leads this army as at its vanguard. This army will never stop until the Earth King's orders are withdrawn. A brutal tempest descends. It's like that one there. I guess it looks like it is like a not Linden. Or not Henley? Or kinda Henley? Henley of the Wild Hunt. I was kinda already wondering if the dead rabbits who seemed kind of, especially the ones that seemed less talkative, were already in this state of blind following, which would make sense. Might have to tag on a different put a use on somebody else. Eventually also Ishii. Probably bring in Medu. I think we're gonna pause soon.
너 마
최. I was hoping to get to like a dungeon entrance, but I can't remember what number we're on. And I know it's gonna be at 48 for the dungeon entrance.
Yahoo,
이기는 편, 우리 편.
이 전투의 명예 따위를 기대하고 있는 건 아니겠지.
정리하겠습니다. 불결한 것. 정리하겠습니다. 불청객은 찌그러져 있도록.
칼날이 잘 되네요. 아마 그 공격이 약점이었겠죠?
이제 쓸만해졌군. 사냥이 성공적이었네요. 이 흐름대로 사냥을 끝내러 가죠.
Variety. I can't remember. No, they don't have law. But I don't even have Sun Shower yet. I haven't seen this one. Curiosity. No, not you. I do a blind obsession, though.
겁나를 내게 바쳐주지.
놀라운 명령이네요. 적을 완벽히 파악하고 있으신 거군요.
이곳은 그분의 초상이요. 가까이서
oh, that's nice.
자세히 보겠는가?
I like that more than your default. A little bit. Just in terms of effect, it seems like at least it's a multi-hit.
No.
Which is almost always the thing I live for with an eco. At least is one of my favorite things to look for in an eco. Of does it heal or does it hit multiple enemies? Those are two things I look for.
Very
nice.
Not quite yet.
He's a 쓸만해 적군.
이 땅과 마님에게 손끝이라도 대려는 자가 있다면.
방해꾼 하나가 사라졌군.
보고 계시는군요, 마님. 칭찬 감사합니다. 불청객들을 남김없이 모조리 처리했습니다.
10 chapters off. Good lord. I did not get very far mainly because of that heat fight. Okay. Well, I'm going to have to pick this up tomorrow, most likely. Definitely, it showed that Mirror Heath was not physically here. He was overwriting. He was an ID, so he was overwriting another person's body. I thought the person would be Matt. This unknown individual, kind of. I thought it would potentially tie in more of essentially maybe like the ring or like some other separate organization to a degree that they used, or even, hey, we used the Dead Rabbits gang, someone who knew Heath, to overwrite and become Heath. So that would have, I felt, made a through line through that. Honestly, Isabel just feels like salt in the wound for her. You didn't mention her before this part, and now she's mentioned and Dish within the same, like, moment. It's kind of fucked. I feel bad for Isabel.